The Associated Press coverage of the Gulf oil spill, which we titled A Failure to Regulate, looked at both BP's failure to follow the rules governing their industry, and also the government's, the regulatory process, failure to enforce the rules.
It's a site that's had devastating consequences. The severed BP well spewing millions of gallons of oil into the Gulf.
The rules were relaxed, not enforced, and basically when we really delved into what was going on in the Gulf of Mexico, we discovered a long laundry list, sort of disheartening really, that left the environment unprotected. For example, we looked at plans that allowed BP to escape seriously planning for a major disaster, because they basically said, well, that'll never happen. And so therefore they sort of like just avoided having the plan for exactly what did happen.
This is unacceptable.
As we went through the coverage, we expanded our search and looked at the Gulf in general, and discovered that there were 27,000 abandoned wells in the Gulf of Mexico. They were either categorized as temporarily abandoned or permanently abandoned. Basically, the AP had scores of staffers on this story. It was an unprecedented commitment of manpower to one story. We had science reporters, environmental reporters, investigative reporters, local reporters in the four states in the Gulf that were walking the beach every day, looking in the marshlands. We were basically like looking for when and if the oil would hit land, and then the impact. And some of the photography was extraordinary in terms of showing the impact that the oil had on birds and other wildlife. And I think what our reporting has demonstrated is how much risk there really is when the rules aren't followed, or even worse than that, when the rules are relaxed to begin with. We want to know, why did this happen? How could this have happened? Where were the pitfalls? Who failed in their job? And so we felt it was so important not just to cover what was going on, but why this had occurred. And is there some lesson we can all learn from this to prevent it from happening the next time? We had a lot of challenges covering this story, and one of them was sort of a procedural one. We basically had to file either state open records requests or federal Freedom of Information Act requests to get at the documents we were searching for.
No one routinely inspects abandoned wells.
If you think about some of the damaging information we found about the lack of regulation and reading these emergency plans, well, they existed before the oil spill, but nobody thought to go and read them as carefully as we did after the oil spill. So we've now tried to teach that lesson to all of our reporters. When you're talking about something where there's a regular filing of information, let's try to read that information ahead of time so that we can find the sort of the flaws in the system before the environmental horror story occurs rather than after. Given that the Grantham Prize is so prestigious, it's important to the AP and all of our staffers, because we view environmental reporting as a very important role for us to fill, and it's sort of like a for us a validation of the hard work on this story and similar kinds of stories. For example, right now we're still engaged in covering the nuclear crisis in Japan, and we have the same kind of approach. We're trying to cover the spot story as well as the environmental impact, and look at things from an investigative accountability journalism point of view. And we know when we're recognized, for example, for the Grantham Prize, then we know that our efforts are at least, you know, being recognized for the hard work and sort of telling the public what's going on out there.